A people who walked in darkness has seen a great light. For those dwelling in a land of deep gloom, a light has shone.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father, the love of Christ Jesus, and communion with the Holy Spirit be with each one of you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers, my sisters, we continue to praise God for the mystery of the Incarnation in this Christmas season. Powerful expression of God's love for us. We ask that we might respond to him generously.
I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. O God, you bestow light on all the nations. Grant to your people the gladness of lasting peace, and pour into our hearts that brilliant light by which you purified the minds of our fathers in faith. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son. He lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, if God so loved us, we must also love one another. No one has ever seen God, yet if we love one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us. This is how we know that we remain in him and him in us, that he is given of his Spirit. Moreover, we have seen and testify that the Father sent his Son as Savior of the world. Whoever acknowledges that Jesus is the Son of God, God remains in him and he in God. We have come to know and to believe in the love that God has for us. God is love, and whoever remains in love remains in God and God in him. In this is love brought to perfection among us, that we have confidence on the day of judgment, because as he is, so are we in this world. There is no fear in love, but perfect love drives out fear, because fear has to do with punishment, and so one who fears is not yet perfect in love. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you.
Lord, every nation on earth will adore you.
O God, with your judgment, endow your king, and with your justice, the king's son. He shall govern your people with justice and your afflicted ones with judgment.
Lord, every nation on earth will adore you.
The kings of Tarshish and the isles shall offer gifts. The kings of Arabia and Seba will bring tribute.
Lord, every nation on earth will adore you.
For he shall rescue the poor when he cries out, and the afflicted when he has no one to help him. He shall have pity for the lowly and the poor. The lives of the poor he shall save. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Glory to you, O Christ, proclaimed to the Gentiles. Glory to you, O Christ, believed in throughout the world. Alleluia. 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 The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
After the 5,000 had eaten and were satisfied, Jesus made his disciples get into the boat and precede him to the other side toward Bethsaida while he dismissed the crowd. And when he had taken leave of them, he went off to the mountains to pray. When it was evening, the boat was far out on the sea, and he was alone on the shore. There he saw that they were tossed about while rowing, for the wind was against them. About the fourth watch of the night, he came toward them walking on the sea. He meant to pass by them. But when they saw him walking on the sea, they thought it was a ghost and cried out. They had all seen him and were terrified. But at once he spoke with them. Take courage. It is I. Do not be afraid. He got into the boat with them, and the wind died down. They were completely astounded. They had not understood the incident of the loaves. On the contrary, their hearts were hardened. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
When you look at the Gospel quickly, kind of that last two lines there, they had not understood the incident of the loaves and the fishes. And on the contrary, their hearts were hardened. Sometimes, maybe that's us as we come forward to the table here, and we try and receive Christ in the precious blood and the body, the bread, but we don't quite understand what's really taking place. And maybe sometimes our hearts are hardened, and we become terrified at what's going on. Jesus then kind of knew all that, of course, and obviously he sent them, at the beginning of the gospel, he sent them on their way alone. And I think sometimes that's what happens to us too. We are out here in the world, you know, in our families, in our workplaces, and we're on our own kind of way to experience. Not that Jesus isn't with us, but we're out there to experience everything alone. And maybe this pandemic and all that goes with it, and maybe just your everyday life, you know, trying to get through, you know, providing food for other people or whatever the situation may be, we find ourselves in a rough way. And until we realize that Jesus comes to us in the Eucharist, and then we can see him helping us out every day, like he came to the apostles and disciples on that boat, and he calmed everything down, then I think we can realize that he is with us always, and he will help us through every situation, which he did in the boat there. One of the first things that Lynn did on the first reading was kind of reading from the letter of St. John, and he tells us exactly, if we understand the Eucharist and are the Word of God as we hear it, it calls us to love like he loves. And if we find ourselves loving other people, we know then that God is in us and we are all in God. So the point, I guess, would be simply this. We come to the Eucharist. We've looked for Jesus to be with us throughout it. But he calls us to this element of love, this level of love that is God-like. And so today we need to ask ourselves, do I understand the Eucharist? Has it helped me? Has it pushed me on? Does it calm me, my fears down through all the different situations in life? Do I love others like God, Jesus has loved them? And if so, do I feel it? And so we need to ask ourselves, where can I go one step further to live out the gospel in our lives?
We pray with confidence. God is faithful to promises made to us.
We pray for all members of the church. May they continue to grow in faith and hope and love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all public authorities. May God grant them humility to be guided by his word. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who feel alone during this season of joy. May the love of the newborn king bring them hope and comfort. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those in our faith community who feel anxious or afraid. May the calming presence of the Lord bring them peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the souls of all the faithful departed, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for your intentions that you bring here today, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Gracious, loving God, we are your people, believing that you hear us. In your way and your time will always answer us, through Christ Jesus, our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever. By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share the divinity of Christ as he humbled himself to share in our humanity.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Lord God, we ask for you. Lord, wash away my iniquities and cleanse me of all my sins. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Amen. O God, you give us the gift of true prayer and of peace. Graciously grant that through this offering, we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty. And by partaking in these sacred mysteries, may we be faithfully united to you and one another in mind and heart. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For this, in this Christmas season, though invisible in his own divine nature, he has appeared visibly in ours. And begotten before all ages, he has begun to exist in time, so that raising up in himself all that was cast down, he might restore unity to all creation and calls straying humankind back to the heavenly kingdom. Joining now with the angels and saints, we praise you in joyful celebration, acclaiming, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. You never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by that same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for the many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate this memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look upon the oblation of your church. Recognize the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son may be filled with his Holy Spirit and become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make each of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your saints, especially with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. O Lord, may this sacrifice of our reconciliation advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to strengthen in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Walker, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for his own. O merciful Father, listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you've gathered here before you, and in your compassion, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, especially Margaret Teeter, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There, we too hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Christ has made us God's sons and daughters, and so we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant to her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. And may the peace of Christ be with each one of you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ bring us to everlasting life.
The communion antiphon, "That life which was with the Father became visible and has appeared to us."
The blood of Christ. Body of Christ, doctor.
Amen.
The body of Christ, my friend.
Amen.
The body of Christ, Al.
Amen.
The body of Christ, my dear. The body of Christ, Betty.
Amen.
The body of Christ, Pat. The body of Christ, my friend. The body of Christ, my friend. The body of Christ, Marianne. The body of Christ, my dear. The body of Christ, Karen. The body of Christ, Craig.
Amen.
Body of Christ, dear. The body of Christ, sister. The body of Christ, sister. Let us pray. O Lord, may your people, whom you guide and sustain in so many ways, experience both now and in the future the remedies which you bestow, so that with the needed solace of things that pass away, we may strive with ever deepened trust for things eternal. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace to proclaim the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. And be a little bit careful. It was slippery on the sidewalks when I came in. It might still be slippery. Watch your step.